What is Chanukah? Why do we eat sufganiyot, spin the dreidel, and light the Chanukiah? Well, it all started with a group of people called the Maccabees. During this time, Israel descended into deep darkness, during 2nd century BC, under the rule of King Antiochus. This leader outlawed the Jewish faith and forbid following God's commandments or keeping the Torah. He defiled the temple and forced the Jewish people to bow down to their Greek gods and to adopt their pagan customs. Many lost their lives when refusing to eat pork, break the Sabbath day, or worship anyone other than the one true God of Israel. This continued until a few brave souls, Judah and his five brothers, formed a small rebellion to fight against the corrupt government and reclaim the temple. Their name, the Maccabees, is an acronym standing for Mi Kamocha Baalim Adonai, translating to Who is like you, O God among the gods. They knew that although they may be small, their God was greater than the enemies they faced. Against all odds, the small yet mighty Maccabee army began winning battles and reconquered the temple, a monumental victory for the Jewish people. Yet legend has it that only a small amount of oil could be found, enough to light the menorah in the temple for just one day. Despite this, God performed a miracle and caused the oil to last for the entire 8 days. This is significant because the Ner Tamid, meaning the eternal flame, was always to be kept lit in the temple, symbolizing how the light of God is to be kept burning in our hearts continually. This is why we light our Chanukiahs for 8 nights. The story of the Maccabees portrays the same spiritual battle still going on today. We have the choice to conform to outside pressure or to pursue God, whatever may be the cost. During Chanukah, we remember that even in the midst of the deepest darkness, light always shines brighter. Yeshua himself declared, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." In fact, one chapter later, as Chanukah was still approaching, Yeshua healed a blind man and restored his sight. This wasn't a random act. This was a profound statement that Yeshua made in connection with Chanukah. He doesn't want us to live as the blind, trapped in darkness. He wants to open our eyes and to bring us into the kingdom of light and invites us to follow him, whatever the cost may be. That is the true heart of Chanukah. That as the darkness gets darker, our lights would shine brighter and we would reflect the light of the world, Yeshua our Messiah. Chanukah Sameach!